Welcome to the first instalment of Neolithic and Bronze Age news. Each week I'll be posting a video summarising the latest archaeological finds and updates from around the world. I'm focusing on these time periods because that's when megaliths were mostly being built and I'm the megalith hunter. But if there's a piece of interesting archaeological news from an earlier date, I'll also include that. Links to all the news sources and anything I find that's particularly useful are in the description below. Number one, new Neolithic structure found at the Tas-Silġ archaeology site in Malta. The multi-period archaeological site of Tas-Silġ in Malta is closed to the public except for by appointment due to ongoing excavations. It was announced this week in Times of Malta that a new Neolithic structure has been discovered, which extends the most ancient part of the site even further than was known previously. Tas-Silġ was first inhabited by the temple people during the Tarshin phase, which lasted from around 3150 to 2500 BCE. Megalithic remains can be seen which once belonged to a temple similar to those found throughout the Maltese islands. There's part of an outer wall, a threshold slab with three libation halls, and various other scattered megaliths on the site. Archaeologists have put forward the idea in the past that there may have been as many as three other temples on the site alongside it. I visited it earlier in the year. You may have seen the photographs on my Instagram feed. It's a great site, but quite confusing for a non-expert to figure out. After the temple period, Tas-Silġ was then reused in the Bronze Age, later on by the Phoenicians, then by the Romans, and during the Byzantine era. At the moment, there's no indication in the news of what the newly found Neolithic structure is, but I'll be following the story closely. Number two, seven Taş Tepeler sites under excavation in Turkey. The Daily Sabah reports that seven of the 12 known Taş Tepeler sites in Turkey are under excavation, which will add a wealth of knowledge to that which is known about these early Neolithic settlements in the area. The Taş Tepeler sites are spread over 200 kilometres and include the famous megalithic enclosures called Göbekli Tepe and Karahan Tepe. Other sites being investigated are Harbet Suvan, Gürçü Tepe, Göztepesi, Tasli Tepe, Surfer Tepe, Ayanla, Yogenberg, Sayburk, Kakmak Tepe and Yeni Mahalle. Additional sites will also be excavated in the near future. The ongoing work at Karahan Tepe has uncovered more than 250 T-shaped pillars, carved animal reliefs and human sculptures. Some of the finds are on display at the Sanliurfa Archaeological Museum. Number three, 100 kilograms of Neolithic artefacts discovered on Nyasha Island. Tomsk State University staff at the Vrem Florinsky Museum of Siberian Archaeology and Ethnography and the company called Siberian Archaeology carried out excavations on Nyasha Island in the Tom River. The investigation was made possible because of very low water levels. Many Neolithic artefacts were recovered from the site, including knives, arrowheads, and pottery sherds. One of the most intriguing finds, which will be published in a scientific journal, is a carving of a human face in a fossilized bone. No permanent settlements seem to have existed along the river, so it's not clear why the Neolithic people who visited the area left so much behind. Number four, Historic England launches the Aerial Archaeological Mapping Explorer. A wonderful tour by Historic England has been launched, which allows the public to view ancient sites virtually. The Guardian reports that thousands of sites are available via this new mapping tool, which uses aerial photographs and LiDAR technology to create a picture of both ancient and more recent historic landscapes. There's plenty available to explore, depending on a person's interest. Many of the sites date back to the Neolithic and include long barrows and causewayed enclosures. There are also Bronze Age, Iron Age, Roman and World War II sites. Much of the sites cannot be seen by the casual observer on the ground, so this tour gives people an overview of that which would otherwise be hidden. I can't wait to explore with this. I've put a link to the tour below, as well as a link to the article. Number five, Bronze Age jar uncovered at the Yümüktepe Hoyuk tumulus in Turkey. The Yümüktepe Hoyuk tumulus in Turkey dates back to around 7000 BCE and has been inhabited by different civilizations over the years. Previous excavation work uncovered Hittite period skulls as well as Neolithic seals. A more recent excavation unearthed a building containing a Middle Bronze Age jar and numerous amounts of pottery and fossilized food. Archaeologists think it may have been an important ceremonial center rather than a private house. Number six, rare Bronze Age sword found in Finland. The Satakunta Museum and Finnish Heritage Agency have announced that in the summer, a metal detectorist found a Bronze Age sword broken into seven pieces in a garden in Finland. The original context is unknown since it seems to have been moved there along with soil when construction took place in the area some years ago. It's thought it may once have been ritually deposited in the Gulf of Panelia, the surrounding area having been heavily populated in the Bronze Age. Such finds are rare in Finland, with only 200 Bronze Age artefacts having been found in the country. So that's it for my first weekly news summary. We've got megaliths, unusual artefacts, and a new way to view ancient landscapes in the UK. For weekly updates on ancient history news and my regular videos, please subscribe to my channel. Don't forget to like this episode and follow me on Instagram for more content.